Hello learners, welcome to Digital System Design course. This is M. Chandrasekhar Reddy, HOD, Department of ECE, SV College of Engineering, Kadapa. So before going to the in detail about digital system design, first to know the modules of digital system design. So in that first module, we will learn about CMOS logic and BiCMOS logic. In second module, we learn about hardware description language, that is VHDL. So how to write the programming and how to write the test bench of different designs like combination and sequence circuits. In third module, we go for combination circuits design like adders, ALU, comparators, by using VHDL language. In fourth module, we go for sequential circuits design, flip-flops, counters, resistors using VHDL. Finally, fifth module, we learn about different case studies using VHDL programming. This is the five modules of digital system design. So nowadays, electronic industry plays a major role in our day-to-day life. So at the same time, digital equipments plays the major role in each and every minute of our life is very important. So the effective way of designing electronic circuits using digital system design is possible and ensure that we reduce the power dissipation. Also, we can use advanced IC technologies. Hello learners, welcome to digital system design. So according to JNTUA University, this course is available for ECE third year first sem. So now we can go for complete details about syllabus of digital system design. So this course divided into the 5 units. In that 5 units, first unit, introduction to logic families, that is CMOS and bipolar logic. In that we will discuss about architecture of CMOS logic, now how to implement the CMOS logic circuits, and what is the noise margin of CMOS logic circuits. Next, second part, we go for bipolar logic. Here also different basic logic circuits implementation using bipolar, like TTL, ECL, and finally comparison of CMOS and bipolar technologies. That is the overview of first unit. In that first unit, in detail syllabus is introduction to logic families, CMOS logic. In that CMOS logic, once again divide into the different types of CMOS logic families. Then you can go for bipolar logic, TTL logic, interfacing of CMOS and TTL logic, emitter coupled logic, comparison of CMOS and bipolar logic, and discuss some standard 74 series ICs related to TTL and CMOS, and finally a comparison of all those things with different specifications. So that is a first unit syllabus. Coming into the second unit, so the name of second unit, hardware description languages. So in that we learn about the basic design structure of VHDL program and architecture of programming part. Now what are the basic elements used in VHDL, like objectives, types, constants, arrays, functions and procedures. And these VHDL
divided into the three major programming ports: data flow, structural design flow, and behavioral design flow. We can write any one of these three modules, and finally we can write test bench about our design. Test bench means we can estimate output before and giving the inputs. So finally we can go for a simulation and synthesis of VHDL language. So that is the second unit description. Next, go for third unit, combination logic design. Combination logic design, we can go for design of decoders, encoders, comparator, multiplexers, comparators, PLDs, ALU, by using the VHDL modules, and also we can write the test bench about all these designs. So that is the combination logic design. Next, go for the fourth unit, sequential designing or sequential machine designing. So in that we can design sequence circuits using VHDL like shift registers, counters, Johnson counters, different types of registers, and study their specifications and implementation using VHDL with standard ICs. That is a sequential machine designing. Next, go for final some case studies of VHDL. That is nothing but a design examples of VHDL. So here we can use the extra of combinational sequentials like a barrel shifter, comparator, 32-bit comparator, 32-bit floating point encoder, and dual priority encoder. Next, you can go for some large applications of flip-flops, PLDs, counters, shift registers, and their VHDL modules. This is the final 15-unit design. So this is the contents of digital system design as per JNTU Anantapur. Okay, thank you one and all.